Hi there, I'm Jennifer from SavorWithJennifer.com, and today we are making roasted butternut and acorn squash with a sage brown butter drizzle. It's delightful. Let's begin. So, we have one butternut squash, one acorn squash. Squash is so easy to prepare, but I think most people do not because they find it intimidating. What's intimidating is the fact that they're hard. So what we're going to do is you'll need two things. A very sharp knife, a very sturdy vegetable peeler. We're going to take the top and bottom off of both of our squashes with said sharp knife. Get rid of them. Next, sturdy vegetable peeler. This is a tool by Microplane. It's actually a cabbage tool, but I have found that this particular vegetable peeler that they have on the end of it, which shreds cabbage and other things like fabulously, is really fantastic for squash. Definitely a go-to tool, and even my kids love roasted squash, so I'm down. Basically, we are going to remove the peel from both of our squash. We're going to cut them in half. We're going to scoop out the seeds, throw the seeds away, and then cut them into 1-inch cubes. Butternut squash is one of the easier squash to peel. I'll be honest, the acorn squash is a bit trickier because it has more ridges. All right, our squashes are peeled. I'm going to cut them in half. And a really sturdy, with maybe a kind of a sharp-edged spoon works best for taking out all the flesh and the seeds. Squash are peeled and seeds are removed. Next, we are going to cut them into a consistent size that helps them to roast at an even rate. And my preference is a 1-inch square. After they're cut into squares, we're going to put all of the squash on a large baking pan. We're going to drizzle it with olive oil, kosher salt, and pepper, and we're going to roast it in a 400 degree oven for 45 to 60 minutes until the desired level of like caramelization and browning and crispiness on the edges of the squash is achieved. I personally like it to be almost like a crunch. Here's the last of the squash. We're going to drizzle all of it with about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Sprinkle it liberally with kosher salt and fresh cracked pepper. Coat everything thoroughly. Put it in our 400 degree oven. You want enough breathing room around each individual piece of squash that it's going to roast and not steam. If you have so much squash crowded onto your pan, either throw away some squash or get a second pan. But this looks like a desired amount. We'll get it in the oven. We'll see in a few.